Hello friends, in this video we will going to discuss about the numbers in the Python. So the numbers, as we discussed, there are types of numbers like integer numbers and floating point numbers, complex numbers, binary numbers, decimals and fractions, and we also have octal, hexadecimal and many types. Numbers can perform the basic operation like addition, multiplication, division, modulus and exponential, etc., as we have basic arithmetic operations. And if we see some of them, like if I print 1 2 3 plus 4 5 3 4 5, so when I run it, and in this you can use this run in Python terminal. So I just use the shortcut key as functional key fi. So when I run it, you get the output as 468, which is the sum of this. And you can perform the division, and when I run it, you got the division output. And when you subtract it, you get the sum difference. And similarly, in order to multiply, we should use star asterisk, you get the multiplied output. And in order to perform the exponential, suppose like we need a 2 power 5, so for that we use 2 double asterisk 5. This is represent the 2 power 5. So when I run it, we got the output as 32. So this is how the exponential works. Let us check the type of this data. I use type function, that is built-in function. So this will tells what is the type of data. So here we got 2 power 5 as 32. So the type is the integer data type. So the class of this type is int. So this is the integer class. And if we have the floating values like 5.3, so when I run it, we got the type as float. So this is how it works. And similarly, we can check it for even complex numbers like 2 plus 4j. So when I run it, we get the class as the complex. There are also some numeric modules like import math. So this is the math library or math module. So in this module, we can import the mathematical operations, like in order to import the pi value, so we can print just like math.py. So here, if we run it, we got the value of the pi. So this is how we import the math and print the values. And we have others like randoms. So random is nothing but which prints the random values. So here we need to pass as random dot random. So this will generate a random number. So when I run it, we got the output here, a random number. So when I run it again, we got another number. So this is the how random function works. And if you want a random number between a range, we use random dot rand integer. So we need to pass a range between, suppose like 5 to 10. So when I run it, we got 10, and then run it again, we got 7. So we can pass any range and it will print the values between the range. So when I run it, we get the values. So this is how random works. If you want to perform the operation like I import the math module, and if I want to print the square root value, we just use math dot square root of value, something like 25, we get output as 5. Yes. So if you want to, this is the type as float. Here we can find that it is a floating point. So if you want to check, we just use type of this. We got the floating type. So if you want to, if you want only integer type, so we can just pass int. We can convert this into the int by passing the integer, like this integer function. So it converted into the int. If you want to observe output, I remove this type, and if we run it again, so we got the 5 as the output, which is the integer data type. So this is how we can convert. We can also convert this into the string str by passing it as str. It is converted into the string, that is 5.0. Actually it is float. Float is converted into the string data type, that is 5.0. So we can run again. We get output as string class, and I remove this all. Suppose I want to print square root of minus 10. So when I run it, it gives an error, math domain error, because negative value is a number. When we do square root of negative value, it gives a complex number, so it won't support. For this we need to import complex math as C math. So when we run it again, sorry, here we need to pass as cmath dot square root. So when I run it again, we got the complex number 3.something j. So this is how the complex values can be also performed. So we can check it, type, and run it again. It is a complex class. So this is how we can handle with the numbers. So see you in the next video with the strings. Thank you.